Hi, how you doing? Thanks for joining me. My name is Derek Mitchell, and I am someone who just likes to talk a little bit about nutrition and how to get things moving better in your life. And today, I have been not I haven't put together anything for about a month. So welcome to fall. I think we came into fall late last month, and it's a beautiful day here in the Niagara region, Ontario, Canada. Just thought I'd talk a little bit about transitions and changing seasons sort of gives us the opportunity to talk about that. I've got my door open today and see. Blurry door? Why is it blurry? There we go. So my front door opening to my deck. Maybe we should have that be the backdrop of today's conversation, or not. Hi again. Okay, so I'm back. Now, so I won't yammer on about nonsense too much, but I just wanted to say hello to everybody who happens to take some time with me. I've been working hard at my new job, working in a basically supporting mobile devices that would be cell phones and tablets. So that's definitely been a challenge. I love the technology, but sometimes people bring some questions that are really tough to answer. But doing the best I can to help people, and that's what I'm all about. So what are you all about? Nutrition-wise, I've been keeping to my keto-friendly routine. I've done a couple of cheats where I've basically eaten on a couple of occasions and will again on Canadian Thanksgiving, which is Monday evening. And once I do my cheats, I go right back to it and get back to eating the way I like to eat, which is, meat, cheese, eggs, some dairy, aside from cheese, of course, some dairy. I limit it, but I do enjoy it. Definitely some seafood is wonderful too. So those kind of foods, and I'm not going to go into a big spiel about what the diet is, but if you do have any questions about what kinds of things you may want to eat if you decide to eat ketogenically, then let me know. This is a journey about late last August 2014. I was about 244 pounds, and I started back on this way of eating again. I had been off of it for a while and gained 50, 60 pounds, and this is about the third major time I worked on, reducing weight using low carbohydrate ketogenic eating. So I've been able to be very successful at keeping it off and still being able to pretty much eat whatever I wanted. And when the things that I, did the healthy, unhealthy foods that I still had a little bit of a craving for now and then, I would eat on those cheat days. So I wouldn't eat bread. I wouldn't eat potatoes, no rice. I'm not a big fan of rice anyway, regardless if I was doing this diet, but I think that minimizing wheat is definitely something I try to do almost to eliminate it. But I do like pizza, but I do make a mozzarella-based pizza as well. So that mozzarella base for the crust, and then build from there by putting on some other cheeses and pepperoni and hot crushed red peppers and so whatever toppings I want, within reason. And that's definitely a good pizza. It's pretty heavy, but it's very tasty. And coconut oil, of course, to supplement the healthy fats that I want to include in the diet. So those are the kind of things that I do on a regular basis to keep to this way of eating, so I don't get cravings for the I call it garbage, carbohydrate garbage, the processed nonsense. I do have cravings now and then for things like ice cream, one of my weaknesses when I wasn't eating this way. So when I have cheat days, I'll eat ice cream and then I'll go back to eating ketogenically the next day or the next meal, depending on what I'm doing. So now we're in the fall, the weather's beautiful. I've had some transitions in my life and working hard at this job, and my home is doing well. So the things that I'm my goals for the next few months, and I don't believe that doing your New Year's resolutions is important. I think it's having goals and trying to work towards them gradually is the best way to move forward. You didn't get fat if you're fat. You didn't get fat overnight. You're not going to get thin overnight, but you can progressively get better thinner, healthier. And I believe that the ketogenic way of eating is a very healthy way of improving your biological health, as well as your mindset too, because it clears it up. You don't have a lot of garbage carbohydrates in your body. Sugar, it doesn't increase your insulin levels and push you to store fat, and it clears your mind. Some people have brain fog, and when you're eating this way, that brain fog disappears. Not necessarily sure. I like to talk, but I'm not necessarily sure when I'm not on keto that I can talk and be very clear about what I'm saying, like I can when I'm eating this type of food. So this morning I had a 3 eggs with cheese omelet, and I was at my mom's, so she was very nice to make it for me. I stayed overnight and visit. It's been a while since I've gone there. So really, this is a transition time. So one of the things that's really hard for me is the friendships that I've developed over the years. There's been some that have been very close that I've had to basically put aside for now because just those friendships aren't working. People change, and it's unfortunate because some of these friendships I thought were a lot more solid than it clearly that they ended up being. However, I've got to be positive and move forward. I mean, I'm not always happy. There's times, days I just, get in bad moods or just a feeling not so great. But most of the time, I'm feeling pretty good physically, emotionally, and trying to build and just enjoy the life that I have and I've been given. So that's what I'm about right now. So I've been rambling on and on and on. What is this about? This is about just trying to set goals to determine what works best for your body. Because each of us have a different tolerance for the different types of foods that we eat. Some people cannot tolerate dairy, and other people tolerate it very well. Some people actually tolerate carbohydrates a lot better than others. I am not one of them, however. So I try to stay away from them the majority of the time. And I've said before when I've done videos is I subscribe to the 90-10 rule. Is 90% of the time, eat the way that I think is best to keep me in a healthy state of body and mind. And the other 10%, every now and then, and maybe only 5%, you cheat a little bit and you eat those things you know that aren't necessarily bad for you, aren't necessarily good for you, excuse me. But you do it because you really enjoy the taste of it and you want to feel like you're not being deprived of anything while you're living your life. It's important that you be active and you go out and do things that you enjoy. For me, it's walking. I used to have a bicycle. I used to bicycle. My parents actually swim at their, and they're older, but they swim in the 70s, so it's great. So those kinds of things keep your cardiovascular system. It helps your circulatory system to be active. On the ketogenic type of eating, it's not necessary or required to exercise, but to keep your body healthy and happy, I think moderate exercise is a good thing to do. Overdoing it stresses out your body. It provides cortisol. Cortisol slows down your efficiency and health and weight loss too. So don't exercise too much and don't push yourself too much, but be active. That's about it for today. So I'm gonna go. This is my day off, so I'm gonna go enjoy some of this really beautiful fall weather here. The trees are changing color and. I don't know if in your region, whoever's watching, if you have the foliage change, but it's definitely a beautiful thing. Going to sit down and watch some television that I've missed over the last while because I've been working hard at my job. And I just want to tell you, if you do have any questions about this way of eating or anything else I've said, please feel free to email me at niagaraedge@gmail.com. Please always feel free to like this video. I always appreciate any likes that you give on YouTube and. If you have any comments, feel free to enter them in the YouTube video at the bottom as well, and I'll be happy to address them or just respond to them, whatever. Definitely like hearing from you who watch. I appreciate you taking some time out of your day to listen to me ramble on, and I hope you have a wonderful day and a wonderful weekend if you're watching this on Friday. Thanks. Take care. Bye.